I'm Graham and I hope everyone's having a great day and welcome to today's video. Now, in today's video, I want to try and address the question of how are smartphones faring in the world of traditional photography? And traditional photography, I'm talking about your compact systems cameras or DSLRs. Now, in this video, I'm going to be pairing the Huawei P20 Pro versus Canon EOS M50. Now, the M50 is the latest in the mirrorless line on the ESM cameras, and it's one that I've adopted as my day-to-day camera. So it'd be interesting to test the Huawei P20 against this particular type of camera. So I'm going to do some studio shots, and if it ever stops raining outside, I'll take the cameras out and try and get some landscape and some portraits if I can. Now, I've been using the iPhone X or 10, as you want to call it, for several months now, and quite impressed with the type of pictures that it can capture. Now, I've had my eyes on the Huawei P20 for a while now because of the triple camera and the fact that you've got a 41 or 40 megapixel sensor there, which can capture raw data. You also get the option to shoot in 10 megapixel mode, which is a 4x pixel binning method to get you down to that 10 megapixel. And it also shoots in 4K, but there's no image stabilization attached to any of the 4K video. So it needs to be shot on a tripod, but I'll be testing 4K video in a later video series for you. The images from smartphones are getting better and better, and the developers are bringing out new features to these cameras way ahead of anything that's been done by the traditional camera manufacturers. It may be to make up for the limitations of these smaller cameras that the effects are being generated, such as fake bokeh or the out of focus depth of field type effects you can get with these cameras now, or the lighting modes that these cameras can simulate. So they're sort of features that the camera manufacturers like Apple and Huawei and Samsung are addressing, but traditional camera manufacturers are just totally ignoring that sort of computational photography at the moment. Okay, let's set the camera up for some tabletop photography and compare the two images. As tabletop photography and product photography is one of the areas that I like to use my traditional camera for, but if I can just use my smartphone to get that quick advertising shot, then that's what I'd like to do. Well, there you are. You've seen the differences between the smartphone, in this case the Huawei P20 Pro, versus the Canon EOS M50. No, I'm going to let you make your own mind up as to the quality of the images from the two products, from the P20 Pro and from the M50. But it's true to say that the smartphones are making great inroads into traditional photography. And it's not going to be long before we find that the image quality from these devices, in most cases for general purpose use, will match the DSLR quality. I'm not talking full frame, I'm talking about your crop frame sensor or your micro four thirds. So it's going to be an interesting 12 months or 2 years when we see developments from the other camera manufacturers, what they can come up with to match Huawei and the likes of the Google Pixel 3, for example. Okay, that's it for this video. Thanks very much for watching. If you like what you see, please do subscribe if you're not already subscribed to my channel. Click the bell notification icon and you'll be warned when I upload any new videos to the channel. Also, check out my photographic blog, and there's lots more information on the Huawei P20 Pro in the mobile photography section on that blog. And on the homepage is the option to join my 3-weekly newsletter. And the newsletter is almost a technical publication in its own right. Things I publish which I don't put on the blog as a way of saying thank you for contributing to watching my channel. Okay, until the next video, thanks again for watching. Please do take care and hope to see you all in the next one. Goodbye for now.